Hello there, and welcome back to part 10 of my EU4 campaign playing as Korea. Looks like I just converted a province to Confucianism. Last episode, I copped the two monarch deaths where my king died, and then shortly after, my queen consort died, which means at the moment, I'm in a regency council. And my heir is still only 7 years old, which means I can't declare war on anyone for still a few years, and my legitimacy is dropping at a rapid speed, which isn't good. Hopefully once he takes the throne, they'll get back up to a good level. So at the moment, I'm just going to be treading water, so to speak. Just building some buildings, restoring my army. Keeping unrest, hopefully to a minimum. And just planning how I'm going to do my next offensive move. I do want to start making inroads on Japan before they get too powerful. But I'm just not really sure how best to go about that. I want to try and use Ming's help with the naval fleet, but I'm not too sure. I'll do another conversion. Next best target will be Mergen, so I send my missionary there. Now I've got a free diplomat, so I'll start rebuilding my spy network in Jiangsha, make sure I've claimed everything I can claim. Now I do want to work on the coastal provinces for my targets. Alternatively, Yeren's got no allies at the moment. So that might actually be a better option. There's no more claims I can make on that particular island where I want, so I might as well pull back this spy. And I'll send him into Yeren. And that's pretty much all I can do at the moment. I'm going to try and sneak in these two more techs before the penalty gets too high. Is there any sign of the Renaissance yet? There's a tiny sign of it all the way over here in the map. It's in Egypt. They had the Renaissance. No sign of it in Asia at all. Now, what's my unrest doing? And where is it the worst? Jiangsha separatists are still the most dangerous, purely because of raw numbers. Ferdan, Igun, and 2-1. I make the Ferdan one pretty much disappear. But I'll leave it, because that's probably should disappear by itself. Very soon, just due to separatism lowering. But I don't want that to fire at its full strength. And Ferdan is causing, it's going to cause 4, if not 5, extra units. Until these issues are sorted out, I can't lower my army maintenance to save money. Spending money on corruption. Missionaries, that's fair enough. This is why I do need to get a few more workshops. There's Ming's relations improved to its maximum again. Yusugi's still quite high. There's not much else I can really do at the moment. It's 70% now. Get my next admin tech, so I'll do that. Courthouse. The problem with a hereditary local nobility is that they tend to value their local interests over those of the rest of the nation. We need to steadily expand the reach of the government, which begins with the most important area of administration, justice. So it gets me 3 more states, and I can now build a yamen, which I believe is a courthouse. It is. I'm not going to build one of those. My main concern is this uprising and the conversion done. I wonder if I can build even one more troop. Well, it's 13-0 now, so that means it's down to, yeah, it's down to 12%, 12,000, which I believe is manageable. So do another conversion. This time I'll go Igon. That's fine, they're already unhappy with me, so I might as well do that. No. Or I guarantee this rebellion to fire. Land technology research useless. Several prominent men in our country are pointing out that the path we are going when it comes to army research is utterly foolish and will amount to nothing. They demand that we stop the current approach and stick with what was good enough for our fathers. I don't want to lose 10 prestige. Given my low legitimacy, it's probably helping my high prestige levels. I'll lose 50 military power. It's not slow down level 8, but it's not too bad. Now, I was going to look at claims on the Janshao area. Ilan Hala seems to be the logical choice. And I've got Yemen as well. I guess I'll do Sisigar first. I can build a building. Alright, so the rebels are now at 80%. So I won't build the building yet, because if there's conflict, I'm going to have to probably pay some money. Army maintenance. Where's my heir? He's 10 years old. How old do you need to be to claim the throne, I wonder? I would love to be able to attack Yeren, before they get an alliance with someone. I could cheekily steal some land very easily. More wars happening in Japan. Yusugi is not involved. The Age of Discovery is ending in 10 years. A still find it amazing that I'm seeing all this land in India. Yet I can't. The peasantry war has broken out in Vijayanagar, which is in India. I can't see what this little island is. ...90% now. It should happen any minute. Hopefully they appear in Igun, as then they will get a attacking... what's the opposite of bonus? Debuff. Because it's forest area. Another claim. And I guess I'll do Bhutia. Looks like Yeren's got some internal problems as well. Still 90. Make sure it's still going to be 12,000. Yep. Hopefully it stays that way. There they go. So they did start in Igun, which is good for me because as you can see they're getting torn apart. Alright. And now with that over, I can relocate my armies to more beneficial areas. I will build another workshop in Bayo, which is here, and that should be my fifth one if I remember correctly. Yes, so that will trigger the mission once built. Conversion done. Two to go. Both the same length and same unity effect, so doesn't make a big difference which one I choose. Now, still not old enough to claim the throne. My workshop has been built, so I've now completed this mission. Build buildings, let us never sit idle, even in peaceful times. Instead, we must use our resources with industry in order to make sure that we have funds available in time if misfortune should strike upon us. Gives me 50 admin power for free, and my tax income is increased by 10 ducats a year, I believe that is, for 25 years. Next goal is to build a treasury to have 2 grand in my bank. Cities demand old rights. Urban dwellers had always existed under a different code of rules than their rural brethren, even in the same state. Just as monarchs looked to curb the privileges of nobles, they often tried to bring cities under more uniform rules and regulations. The cities often resisted these efforts. I'm hoping that... I don't want to lose the stability. My legitimacy is dangerously low. But I feel like when my heir claims the throne... The average claim should boost it. So I'm going to take the risk and I'm going to lose 20 legitimacy. Yeah, it's in the red. Hopefully it doesn't have too much of an effect on the nation. We'll find out though, won't we? It's caused a bit of uprising. That's fine. That's manageable, though. Wicked rumors. There are some very disturbing rumors circulating regarding the missionary we sent to Hulan. According to the rumors, he never used the money we gave him to finance the construction of a new church, but kept it all to himself. Who would have thought such a godly man could be capable of such a thing? ...60% chance of gaining 15 unrest in Hulan. Well, it's already at 9%. So there's already a chance they're gonna... ...pop over. Or I can lose 25 ducats. I think at the moment I'll take the safe route. There's no reason to doubt a man of God and lose 25 ducats. Alright, so I can get military tech 8. Which I will. Pike and shot. The arquebus was easy to use as a weapon, but also inaccurate and slow to fire, leaving its user vulnerable to cavalry charges. Blending with pikemen allowed arquebusiers to fire and then fall back to be shielded by pikemen when enemy cavalry or infantry appeared. Increases my infantry fire and cavalry shock. And I can build a regimental camp. Which I believe camps are used to increase my land force limit. Alright. That puts me at 8, 7, and 8. Let's hope I can just squeeze in this last diplotech. And then I'll probably shut up shop when it comes to... Popular noble. One of our most gregarious nobles has returned from a tour where he regaled foreign courts with stories of our grandeur. Not to mention spending handsomely out of his own pocket. Only a great land could create such a welcome guest. For 10 years, my diplomatic reputation's increased by one. Another claim in Jianshao, either Birija or Hailanbu. I might go for Birija. He's still allied with Ashikaga, which is concerning, and now Mongolia. Is it concerning though, or is that my ticket into attacking Japan and claiming land? Only time will tell. Only time will tell. Yeren's still got some massive issues by the looks of it. They still got no ally. 13. Maybe when the trait. The first personality is gained when coming of age. I read that to be once he turns 15, he takes the throne. Or is it a she? It is a she. I got a, that's right, I had a female heir, didn't I? Once she turns 15, she should claim the throne. Well, I think that might do me for this episode. Lines up with Ainu. I believe that's Ainu there. I just don't really see the value in taking an alliance at this stage. Here's a conversion. So I'll send my last missionary out to 2-1. And I will wrap it up there. Thanks for tuning in, guys. Next episode, I will get my ruler back and I can start declaring some wars. And expand my nation further. And I will see you next time. Thank you and take care out there.